Hello everyone, this is Atinya Sharma of class 11A and today we would like to present our gaming project which we named as Space Safari. So first things first, let us have a glance at our spaceship. So as we can see, it has got a metallic texture and we try to make it a bit futuristic, and we can see the exhaust. Now we dive into the interior and we can see it's quite spacious, many people can be accommodated, and in the front we can see that we have a glass panel on the top. And from the bottom also we can see the exhaust and everything. Now let us have a look at our space station. So here we tried to give every possible detail which a space station should have, like the service module, command module, multiple docking adapters, solar array panels, orbital workshops, and so on and so forth. And it quite resembles the International Space Station, isn't it? We can see different panes, wirings and all if we have a closer look at it. And various chambers have been made so that to facilitate easy transport of the passengers. And this is the front view. If you look from the bottom also, it is quite similar. Now let's have a glance at our scene wherein we will be showing the different planets which we have created. So yeah, the most outer planet, Neptune, we have made its texture in such a way that it displays its name as well as its radius. And for each and every planet, we have done the same. Here we have Uranus also with its radius. And we have coded them in such a way that they will be revolving around the sun. And also will be rotating on their own axis. We even have coded the moon in such a way that it will revolve around the Earth simultaneously. It will follow the orbit of the Earth to revolve around the sun. Here we can see the planet Mercury also, which is the closest planet to the sun, Venus, Earth, and so on. Now, we would like to play the game and see what we have got. So yeah, as the game begins, we can see some particles floating over there. So basically, it's the part of the rocket which gets deattached when it reaches the space, basically providing its fuel. And as we can see, as we go near them, they get collected and we get one score for that. And not to forget, we have also added a rolling function in our spaceship in order to make the player experience that how exactly a spaceship feels to be in the space, because it is vulnerable to many kind of forces, be it gravity, magnetic force. So even if we try to stabilize the ship, it will float a bit on its own. We can even see some chunk of asteroids. And in front of us, it is a huge chunk of an asteroid forming a belt. It is also known as the Kuiper's belt, which is found between the planet Mars and Jupiter. We can also see it is revolving around the sun. Now we would like to go close to the sun and see the interior of the Kuiper's belt. We can also see the distinct stars and nebulas in the background, which are shining. And now we are entering from the Kuiper's belt, and nearby we just saw the sun, and other planets are also there, like Mercury, Earth, Venus. And the main objective of a game is to promote collection of space junk so that we could reduce space pollution. So that's our simple game. I hope you liked it. Thank you.